Hi everyone, it's me again. So that would mean that it's actually another episode of unit review for this Park Clematis. Okay, yes, you can see from the screen here that actually I have circled out all the three bedroom. PP stands for premium. Okay, so the difference basically between three bedroom premium and three bedroom is the size. So where did the extra space went into? The extra space actually went into this helper room and the small little toilet for this, the helper's toilet, so to speak. Later you can actually see from the floor plan. But before that, I would like to actually run through this site plan with you. Okay, same thing, I've actually circled them in blue this time round. Okay, so you can actually see that none of the units are actually facing AYE and the Avenue 6 exchange, which is a good thing. One thing that I want to point out to you is that step 24, you can see from here, is actually partially obscured by Regent Park once again. Okay, and then 54. Okay, 54 is, in my personal opinion, one of the worst steps to be, again because of the proximity towards the tennis court and AYE, that's for sure. Okay, 57 is something that you can actually consider because there is no west sun and you are actually having an unblocked view of the pool, the main pool. And also, if you are not very west sun adverse, okay, you can actually look at this 62 and 7. Okay, because I have to be honest with you, these two in my opinion has a very very great view because they are facing the landed estate, but both balconies are actually having some sort of a west sun, which is something that you cannot change, so you must be prepared to live with it. That will depend on your how you feel about the west sun. Some people are really okay with it and some people are totally no way. So that will depend on what you choose in this unit selection, because you can tell for all the units for this three bedroom premium, they are either facing the west sun or they're facing the morning sun. So if you're adverse to the west sun, then the very obvious choice here is stack 8 here, right here. This is actually 3 bedroom premium, the largest stack in the signature. Okay, so those in white, like I've said earlier in the earlier episodes, 8E, D, C and B, they belong to this series called Contemporary. So 8A and 8F actually belong to the series called Elegance. And 6 and 6A finally is where the signature is actually situated. So for these two stacks, obviously I would say that both of them are the best, besides the point that they are bigger, so probably you have to fork out more. Okay, but besides that fact, 7 will be having a better view but facing west sun. Okay, 8 will not be as good view because your balcony will be facing directly towards the condo across the road from Jalan Lempeng, which is actually the trailing. You'll be facing them directly for your balcony. Of course, your rooms will still be having a bit of an unblocked view for the landed estate, but we are actually looking at quite a slight difference in terms of view for 7 and 8 itself. Okay, so without further ado, I'll actually run through the floor plan with you. Okay, you can see here that 54 is actually a flip mirror image of this layout that you see. This, what you're seeing here, this is stack 42 and 57. So to picture 54, right, you actually have to flip this floor plan along the y-axis here. So you can see that 54 is actually here and west is coming in from here. So 54, you'll be getting west sun in your balcony here. Okay, part of your balcony, not entirely, but it's, I would say it's almost the full balcony. and your bedroom too, you'll be getting west sun as well. Not forgetting that probably your view will be partially obscured by this block 8F here. Okay, so this is actually not very, very ideal in my opinion. Okay, and then the key difference that I want to point out to you earlier, which I mentioned, that the premium difference is actually whereby you will get, same thing, you get an enclosed kitchen. Of course, everything else is slightly bigger. Okay, you can actually download the brochure and compare the size with a 3-bedroom. Here, what you're getting is actually, they call it store, which you can convert it into a helper's room as well. You also have a small little WC here for the helper. So you can, you actually have three washroom in total. Okay, so this is something that you have to take note. As for 62, which I said was one of the better ones in my opinion, if you are not concerned about the west sun, it's also because, okay, this is, for your information, this is step 24, which I mentioned that you will be partially looking into the region condo. The region is, region condominium is actually this plot of the square piece of empty plot here, lah, this blank space here. So 24, you can see that actually your balcony, your two bedrooms, these two master and the bedroom two, is actually facing, potentially looking into region condos, somebody's region condos unit, lah, if you're taking the mid floor units. But having said that, you can rest assured that you are not going to be getting any west sun at all. On the flip side, 62, if you, once again, you flip this along the y-axis, okay, you'll be looking at that you realize that actually your balcony is getting quite a bit of a west sun, okay, but then again, once again, you're facing towards the Faber Estate. So this entire stretch from the balcony bedroom two and master bedroom, you are not getting any block view at all. So so to speak, is unblocked, okay, which is, I would say, the view should be quite spectacular, lah, but you have to decide for yourself whether, given Singapore's weather, are you able to put up with the west sun for the rest of your time living in Park Clematis or not. Okay, definitely it will affect your resale price down the line, lah, because everybody's always talking about west sun, west sun, we don't want west sun, we don't want west sun. So this is something that you have to take note, lah. So it's a trade-off. You get a west sun, you get a better view. But if you don't want the west sun, you get a morning sun, then you have a slightly inferior view. Okay? Okay, so now we come to the signature collection of this entire project. Okay, so you can see from here that stack 7 and 8. Okay? So this is actually the layout for stack 7. As I have mentioned, the west is coming in from the left here and stack 7 is here. So your balcony will be getting a direct hit of the west sun. And bearing in mind that this is actually the landed estate. So no matter which floor unit that you are getting, you can be quite assured that the west sun will come in all the way even to cover your partial living room. So this is something that you have to be prepared for. Okay, besides that, okay, other than that, okay, stack 7's view is also entirely unblocked in this manner. You can see here that the living room windows, the bedroom 3, 2, and even all 3 bedrooms and even the master bedroom, they are unblocked because they are facing in this direction where the landed estate is also. Of course, there's a Nanhua Primary School here, but the school will be of little interference to your view. And of course, in terms of noise, the weekends when you're home, they have no classes, so there will be not much of a noise in that sense. Okay, so for stack 7 and 8, something special here is that both you get private lift, okay, which actually opens out into the foyer here, and you can have some additional shoe space here. They actually designed it for you here already. shoe cabinet. I believe this is already built in, okay? And also you get a bigger helper's room called the store. So this can double as a store cum helper's room. And then the WC is here, and then there's actually a secondary exit, the back door also called. And also this kitchen is definitely much more spacious than the previous two that I've actually shown you. You can compare for yourself here, okay? You can actually download the brochure and look at it to scale and measure it for yourself. You can see that the kitchen here for stack 7 and 8 is actually much more decent and in its entirety, so to speak. Okay, so for master room, you'll be getting a walk-in wardrobe as well. And once again, I remind you that if you are adverse to West Sun, I would strongly encourage you to have stack 8. Because stack 8, you'll be getting the morning sun in your balcony, into your living. Okay, you have to fit this along the y-axis. So you can imagine that for stack 8, your balcony will be facing the east instead of the west. Okay, and then for the view here wise, yes, you will still be looking at part of the landed estate. But I do suspect that actually a bit of the living might be looking into the condo across the Jalan Lempeng Road, which is called the Three Ling. One of the blocks is actually in the direction. It will not be entirely obscuring your view of the living room, okay? But what I can tell you is your balcony definitely will be facing one of the blocks for Three Ling. Yeah. So this is something that you have to take note. I've actually opened up the street directory. So again, stack 8 is here, okay? For block 6A, right? So stack 8 is actually here, where the, so you can see from here. So your balcony is actually looking directly at this block 28B of this trailing project. So you have to ask yourself whether you are okay with that. So whereas the trade-off, the both units, they have very different trade-off. One is actually looking into another project, another block. Although it may look like it's quite a distance away, but I have to remind you that things are not the way it is on actual site. Because this road is actually a very small little road, that's all. So the distance between 6A and this 28B might be shorter than what you can envision on the map. So you have to actually go down and see for yourself. Okay? And then stack 7 is what I'm saying, that your balcony will be facing the landed estate. Okay, but because of the landed estate, once again, the pro can become the con and the con can become the pro. So because of the fact that you're facing landed estate, right, your balcony will be getting a full-on direct west sun hit. So when it comes to the three-bedroom premium selection, okay, there's only one major factor that you have to bear in mind when you're selecting which stack. Okay, you have to seriously ask yourself, are you able to live with the west sun shining into your house for as long as you are there, maybe 5 years, I don't know, for as long as you are living there. So you have to ask yourself, because all the stacks are either facing the west or facing the east. Okay, so as for view wise, if you ask me, once again, we compare here, you can see that actually 39 is having a good pool view, but you're facing the west sun. Okay, so but for this, I think the obvious choice would be, if you were to pick the type 1 and type 2 for the premium, the obvious choice, if you ask me, I would definitely pick 57. This is kind of a no-brainer, because I'll be having the entire pool view, which is unblocked, okay, and I will not be getting any west sun. Okay, so if you ask me, ultimately it really depends on what's your feeling to the wet sun. I know of people who are entirely okay with the wet sun. They can entirely live with the concept of having a wet sun shining to their house. So that's all for me now. Okay, once again, you can actually go to our website www.lovelyhomes.com.sg to download the brochures and see and analyze it for yourself. Okay, once again, thank you for watching. If you find this video informative, please do share with your friends and do like and subscribe to our channel. And also do share with your friends if you think that this has helped you in your selection and understanding this project better. My name is Edwin. That's all for me for now. I will see you in the next video for 3-bedroom dual key. Okay, thank you very much. Bye-bye.